Now, one of the very interesting tool in Photoshop is your brush tool. As you can see, if you click on this, there are four tools are present. Number one is a brush tool. Number two is the pencil tool. Number three is color replacement tool. And number four is a mixer brush tool. So let us assume I'm selecting this brush tool. If after selecting this brush tool, over here you can check out various options. Number one here is that what kind of brush you want to use. Here it is representing the shapes of the brushes and the size of the brush, and it is also representing what is the hardness that you want to use. And then you have the mode, and then you have opacity of the brush and flow and smoothing and so on. So let me just give you a simple example of this, how you can use this brush tool. So this is the kind of digital vacuum pad that I'm using. Now with this digital vacuum pad, I can write something onto the screen with the help of this brush tool. So just go to this brush tool and you can just decrease the size. Let us assume I'm making the size of this tool as 9. Now go to this, and with the help of this digital vacuum pad, I can also write something. For example, my name is Himanshu. Our website is www.digidigimento.com. So I can use this brush tool to perform different actions. So this is, I'm using my name, I'm using Digimento. I can also change the size of the brush. I can also change the size and shape of the brush. For example, this is representing the size and this is representing the shape. So if I change the shape of the brush, so this Himanshu will be written something like this. So just for example, after increasing the size here, let us assume I'm taking the size as 12, 15. So if I just write H, so Himanshu is written something like this. If I change the shape of the brush as this one, so after changing the shape of the brush, let us assume this is the shape of the brush. So if I write Himanshu, it will be written something like this. If I just change the shape of the brush, assume this is the shape of the brush, in that case, this is the kind of pattern that I'm going to get for the brush. So I can write Himanshu with this particular pattern. If I change the shape of the brush, assume the shape of the brush is this is the shape of the brush and size is, let us say, 17. Now in that case, it will write something like this. So you can use this brush to draw something onto the image. You can use this brush to maybe doing some kind of drawing. For example, this is an image. Now you can use this brushes to do makeups on various artists also. For example, I'm using this brush which is of size, let us say, 14. So I can use this brush to do some kind of makeup effect with some image. So let us show you with a better example. Let me just increase the size of the brush and let me decrease the opacity of the brush. Okay, now you can see that I can use this brush to do some kind of makeup for a given artist. Okay, so this is the image of Angelina Jolie. I can use this brush to do some makeup with this image. Okay, I can perform different actions with it. Maybe I just want to color the lips. So I'll select this color. I'll make this opacity as less than 30%. And I can just even color the lips. So you can see there's some slight change in the color. I'm just coloring it in the red color. So there are various things that you can use with the help of brushes also. As you can see, this color of the lips has changed. In the same way, I can perform various actions with the brushes. In the same way, there's another tool here, which is your pencil tool. If you just click on this, right click on this, you'll see there's a pencil tool. So this pencil tool is just like a brush tool, but as you can see, this is behaving like a pencil. If you see here, there are various presets of the pencil. You can increase the size of the pencil. Let us say the size is 9. Now I can just write something onto the skin and it will behave like I'm writing with the help of a pencil. So there are various shapes of the pencil that is also present. Okay, so you can use various shapes of the pencil, you can use various flow of the pencils, and accordingly you can use this pencil as a brush. Now the third brush is the color replacement brush. Now this color replacement brush is used to replace the color. For example, this is an image. I want to replace some specific color. So this color is replaced. So how it is working is, select the color replacement brush. Then select the tolerance. So let us assume I'm making the tolerance as 100, and here I'm selecting the color as red. So I'm taking this yellow color and here I'm applying this color replacement brush. Okay, so as you can see, the color of this particular image is changed. You can use this color replacement brush in many ways. So this is showing how it is you can create it, you can use some continuous sampling, you can use sampling once, you can use sampling background switch. There are many options that is present even with this color replacement brush, and you can use the spacing harder and so many things. So this is again a part of brush. So as you can see, if you go to the darker section, it will replace it in a darker section. If you go to the smaller section, you can replace it in the smaller section. Accordingly, you can replace this particular color in your image. Okay, so this is how the color replacement brush works. And then you have the next color, which is mixer brush. So again, you can use this mixer brush to mix two colors. So as you can see, I can just mix two colors this way. So I can use this mixer color brush here also, so that no one will be able to find the end point. So let us assume I'm increasing the size as 50. Now use this mixer color. See, you can use this mixer color even to do makeups for celebrities and their images. Okay, so you can mix different colors, you can use these colors to mix different shapes in any photographs. Okay, so this is how you can use a mixer color brush. And this is all about brushes, so you don't have to require in-depth knowledge of brushes. So we'll see about if it is required. So this is mixer brush. Then the next brush here is the clone stamp tool. In the next video, let us look at the clone stamp tool brush.